Let's stay within the health sector. Work has started on the construction of a five-story building to replace the long-stalled maternal and children's block project at the Okonfo-Nochi Teaching Hospital. Excavation of the project site is ongoing as contractors prepare to demolish the existing structure. After about 40 decades of neglect, the existing building failed a structural integrity test. Nanaya Ojima joined a tour of the structure by the Ministry of Health.
The new building will be constructed with a 138 million euro budget already secured for the project. The bed capacity will, however, be reduced by 250. Head of Architecture at the Ministry of Health, Richard van der Poy, briefed journalists on the scope of the proposed new structure.
Within 3 years, the contractor promises to finish this structure, including demolishing the existing one. I'm in discussions with Okonfo-Nochi to finalize the detailed internal layouts. And this building is going to have six floors with one sub-basement and then one floor podium for the outpatients department we have. Almost 200 spaces, car parking.
Management of Okonfo-Nochi Teaching Hospital is in support of the demolition of the existing structure. Dr. Oheneba Osu Danso is Chief Executive Officer.
The hospital's main interests currently are the following. That it should not affect the duration or expected completion date of the project. That it should add extra value to what will have been derived from the existing one. That it should be scalable in the immediate future to meet the additional space so urgently required by the hospital. Because as you will learn later, the new scheme has had to reduce the scope.
The Ministry of Health says the long-stalled maternity and children's block fails to meet the minimum standard required by the building regulations. Emmanuel Asabre is project manager for Akito Consult, consultant to the contractor.
Be able to peel off the iron rod. Now, it shows the extent of the rust. Now, try the concrete. Now, concrete shouldn't be this way. Not under any circumstances. Even block work will not peel if you touch it. It shows you the level of deterioration we have currently. Because of the need to try to resolve the issue, these new columns were attempted by the new contractor who came in. Even this still didn't work. What it means is that if we are to work on this, it means that we have to make it bigger. And this is what we call jacketing, by encasing it again. Encasing it, we are losing space and not getting any value for money. And these are some of the things that virtually led to it. And if you see the way we dug the foundation, what it means is that when we go to the top, you see what we mean. We are meant that we are supposed to demolish all these to be able to work on the foundations on the ground before we go up, which then doesn't add up. So one of the investigations we did to see what we had, every concrete needs a certain minimum cover. Currently, these do not meet the minimum covers. So we did this to see how much the rust is running through it. And you can see how it interconnects. So once it's rusting, it goes through the whole facility. And the thickness of the slab we're dealing with. If you look at this, you realize that the bar sizing, first of all, is too small. The detailing is not as it's supposed to be, and it's too thin.
Construction firm contractor says the construction of the new building and demolition of the old structure will progress concurrently. Various governments since 1976 have worked on the project at various stages without any hope of conclusion. A Joy News documentary by Seth Kwame Boateng titled Next to Die, highlighting challenges of mothers, compelled the government to source funding to complete the project. For Joy News, Nanaya Ojima reporting.